The Earth is not being very friendly to us lately. It's a hard truth that 2021 is the very difficult period for worldwide people. Endless suffering seems to be a new normal. The heat waves, drought, wildfires, rains and floods makes us all feel miserable. If you dig into these news, you may notice a common word, that's climate change. To know more about this, continue watching. Hi, I'm Benny Long. In this video, I'm talking about the journey of Earth's climate change. Climate researchers use every possible way to study the full history of Earth's climate, from the latest satellite observations to samples of prehistoric ice extracted from glaciers. According to their observation, our planet Earth is getting warmer. Yes, most of us agree with them. I'm not going to prove that fact in this video, but I would like to walk you through how we got here. Long ago, our Earth was the most beautiful and comfortable place for all living beings, and it is the only planet where we can live. What makes it so unique? It's greenhouse gases. You might be surprised to hear this, but it's true that greenhouse gases are a great blessing to us. Earth's atmosphere is the blanket of gases that surrounds our home planet. When sunlight reaches the Earth, some energy is reflected into the space. Some of the heat is absorbed by the gases in the atmosphere and radiated in all directions, warming the Earth. These heat-trapping gases are called greenhouse gases. If it weren't for the greenhouse gases, Earth's ocean would be frozen solid. Yes, it is them who keep our Earth warm enough to all living beings to live. The six main greenhouse gases in our atmosphere are water vapor, methane, nitrous oxide, chlorofluorocarbons, ozone, and carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is so good at holding in heat from the sun that even a small increase in carbon dioxide in the atmosphere can cause Earth to get even warmer. It is a colorless, odorless gas that is produced naturally when humans and animals breathe. Plants take in this carbon dioxide and give away oxygen. Thus, plants and animals depend on each other, and so the cycle remained balanced. Everything was going well until the invention of steam engine, and then the world changed forever. This big change is called the Industrial Revolution. Steam engines use hot steam from boiling water to drive the pistons back and forth. This steam was produced by heating water by burning coal. That's the dangerous part. Now, you may wonder what is coal and why it's so dangerous. For hundreds of millions of years, plants have lived and died. Their remains have gotten buried deep beneath Earth's surface. The heat and pressure turned the plants into coal. This coal is a carbon-rich material. When coal burns, its carbon combines with oxygen in the air and forms carbon dioxide. Later, we started burning coal for electricity generation. Even now, most of our electricity comes from burning fossil fuels, mostly coal and natural gas. As technology grows, we started traveling a lot. Cars, trains, buses, and trucks, those run on conventional gasoline, diesel, and other fuels, emit carbon dioxide. So as we burn more and more coal, the carbon dioxide is produced more and more, which leads to the imbalance in the cycle. As we all know, too much of anything is bad. The excess carbon dioxide is warming up our planet slowly. This human-induced warming has reached approximately 1 degree Celsius above the pre-industrial level in 2017. If this continues, the global warming is likely to increase 1.5 degrees Celsius between 2030 and 2052. The global sea level has risen by about 8 inches since 1880. This is projected to rise another 1 to 8 feet by 2100. This is the result of added water from melting icelands and expansion of seawater as it warms. The Arctic Ocean is expected to become ice-free in summer before mid-century. Understanding this danger, world leaders signed an agreement in 2015 known as Paris Agreement. Its goal is to limit global warming to well below 2, preferably to 1.5 degrees Celsius compared to pre-industrial levels. A few degrees makes a big difference. We may wonder what is the big difference between 1.5 degrees Celsius increase and 2 degrees Celsius increase. Frequency and magnitude of extreme weather events like wildfire, storm, floods, drought and heat waves due to this half degree differential would increase exponentially. On August 9, 2021, Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, the IPCC, released its sixth assessment report after 8 years of research. This report has 234 authors and was subjected to review from numerous climate experts and government officials. It states global warming of 1.5 degrees Celsius and 2 degrees Celsius will be exceeding during the 21st century unless deep reduction in carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gas emissions occur in the coming decades. Sea levels are rising faster. Indian Ocean is warming faster than the global average. The worst part is, even if we manage to immediately stop burning fossil fuels, the already released carbon dioxide will continue to warm the planet for a while. That makes achieving the Paris Agreement more challenging. What can we do now? It's now time to take baby steps. Let's spread the news and make everyone aware of this danger, so that our political leaders will be pressured to take a wise decision. Let us all fight together. Let's make the earth a peaceful place for our next generation. If you are interested to know the alternative method of producing electricity, I have few videos on renewable energy solutions. Thank you so much for watching. See you in my next video.